17 years later. St. Pancras Hotel, a grand building with a clock tower. Inside nearby King's Cross Station, a dark-haired boy of 11 wearing a striped shirt wheels a trolley piled with luggage and an animal cage along a platform. A red-haired girl sits on the trolley of an older dark-haired boy walking beside him. The trolley stops and the girl jumps off. The older boy runs, pushing the trolley at speed into a brick pillar between the platforms. He and the trolley disappear. The first boy looks nervous. Harry walks up to him and rests a hand on his shoulder.
Together.
The boy nods, and the two of them push the trolley into the pillar. They emerge on the other side, onto platform 9 3/4, where a steam engine, a Hogwarts Express, sits waiting. Ginny and the red-haired girl, Lily, follow them. They see Draco Malfoy with his wife, Astoria, and son, Scorpius. In their house colors of scarlet and gold, members of the Gryffindor Quidditch team board the train. The younger Potter has a ferret in the cage. Little sister Lily chases a paper bird flying off the platform. Ron and Hermione fuss over their daughter Rose.
Jumper.
Ron has an arm around their small son, Hugo.
Here they come.
They turn to see the Potters. Young Potter hangs back, then bends down to tie his shoelace. Ginny and Harry exchange a look before Harry returns to their son. He crouches down beside him.
Dad, what if I am put in Slytherin?
Albus Severus Potter. You were named after two headmasters of Hogwarts. One of them was a Slytherin, and he was the bravest man I've ever known.
But just say that I am.
Then Slytherin House will have gained a wonderful young wizard. But listen, if it really means that much to you, you can choose Gryffindor. The Sorting Hat takes your choice into account.
Really?
Really.
Albus tightly. On the train, Albus ducks to avoid a whizbang and enters a compartment. He sits by the window next to his older brother James and opposite his cousin Rose. The chocolate frog crawling up the window leaps into Rose's hand. On the platform, her mum puts a hand in her mouth and smiles. The children wave to their parents and siblings as the train steams out of platform 9 3/4. The Weasleys and the Potters stand together watching. Excited children wave out of the windows. Hermione sighs deeply. Ron, Hermione and Harry give a nostalgic smile as the train leaves for Hogwarts.